everybody. This is one of my favorite dogs, AJ. He is a beautiful black Pomeranian, and we are going to groom this baby today. Do you see all this hair? Disregard the barking. We do have more dogs here, and some of them are vocal. Hey, you're right, baby. So we're going to get started, okay? Let me show you some tools that you're going to need. This is one of my favorite brushes. This is a Chris Christensen brush. I have it in several colors. And in order to do a proper groom, you need a good comb. Some people say, what combs do you use? Do you see the teeth on this comb? How close together they are? Then this is a larger comb. They're close. These are wide. That's a little messed up right there. A good comb. If you cannot get a comb through your dog, you cannot get a good grooming. So you will see a lot of people talking about, my dog wasn't matted, blah, blah, blah. If you cannot get a comb through your dog, you cannot properly groom your dog. So we're about to get started. 1 second. This is going to get a little loud, so I'm going to show you a little bit of a, I know, this is my dryer. You can turn your volume down, but you actually need to blow out the coat and brush the coat. Okay, I'm going to show you something. If you notice, the dog is facing that direction. That way the air is blowing towards that direction. I do not want to blow air and it go inside the dog's ear canal. You have to be very careful with that. You don't want to stretch your dog out, okay? Blowing out this whole dog. But do you see the difference just from that? Look, now I can actually get a comb through that section. This side's not done. I cannot get a comb through. But look at this. Now I'm going to do that to the whole dog, Mr. AJ. And then I will start the video again and then we will start the grooming process. Okay, so I have combed through this dog. I have combed through, brushed, combed. This is a ton of undercoat that came out of this dog. Now, this dog comes in on a regular basis. This dog comes in every 6 weeks. Every 6 weeks. In order to get your dog on a good schedule to where they don't have to be shaved down or go through torturous brush outs. And I say torturous, but I won't torture a dog, okay? You need to put your dog on a regular schedule. I'm seeing a lot of videos of people and their dogs with all the undercoat and tangles and matting, and they get their dogs done once a year, and that's just not cool. Dogs should be groomed more than once a year. Just picture only giving yourself a shower once a year. So we're going to start the groom. Here's some of the undercoat. I will throw that away. This is Mr. AJ. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do his pads. If you are not a groomer and you do not know what you're doing, I do not recommend taking a 30 blade to anything. Because these blades are like surgical blades and you can cut the dog. Now notice I'm lifting the leg up and doing the foot. I am not pulling the leg out. This is an older dog and I do not want to hurt the dog. And I'm going to just go and I'm going to get the pen. AJ is a wonderful dog. I have groomed him several times. You'll see his little videos on TikTok and everything else. So I'm just going to lift the paw. And this is what you get when your dog's on a regular schedule. You get a well-behaved groomed dog. The age of one is not the time to start getting your dog groomed. You need to get your dog acclimated as a puppy. Don't wait till they're 1, 2, 3 years old. If you buy your dog from a breeder, if they are a reputable breeder, they can give you the advice you need for grooming. If they tell you your dog does not need to be groomed, they're lying. Every dog with hair needs to be groomed, even if it's a bath and a brush out. Labs shed. Doodles shed. Standard poodles do not shed. They're hypoallergenic. But you still need to get them groomed. You still need to get them groomed. All right, so the pads are done. And now I'm going to do the potty areas. No, I keep... I do not use a 30 on this. I do the back end and I do the belly. Belly's clean. The potty area is clean. Just around there, and we're going to scissor that up. Alright, let's talk scissors. I use several pairs of scissors on one dog. Okay? Several pairs. These are a long curve. I do not buy my scissors at Walmart or Amazon. I get them from a actual scissor, grooming scissor company. There's several you can choose from, but I do not just use one pair, okay?